No matter the product, it's only as good as the quality and longevity it offers the end user. To better understand what goes behind a German-engineered product, we spent some time at the R&D labs of Bilstein Suspension in Ennepetal, Germany.
So again, welcome to the lab. Yeah, we are working here on two shifts with the colleagues here. So from the one side, every new damper which is produced there comes here at the end of line for shipping audit.
Okay.
So every new product which is industrialized first time gets a shipping audit.
Okay.
100%. Mm-hmm. Then we have standard sealed inspections. So the first parts of, for example, from welding, they come here to be inspected by the colleagues from quality because they are better, they're educated for this.
Okay. Yeah?
Then we have also serial controls of the painting line. So once per week, we get a part from the painting line, comes here for a corrosion test. Look on this also.
So that's just testing like the mix of the paint or the batch of that
paint?
Yes,
exactly. If the mix is still okay, if the paint is okay, then we can look then there, some stretches and so on. Mm-hmm. And we also, and this colleagues here are not all doing parts for the aftermarket. We have also our test center here for the OE parts. So all new OE products which are produced here or tested there, we check also some prototypes of them.
Okay.
So we are very
A lot comes through here, yeah.
Yes, a lot of this.
Today we'd be learning about the four main testing categories: dimensional, material, weatherproofing, and analysis and diagnostic.
Should we show some tests?
That'd be great.
Let's start with a 3D measurement machine.
Yeah.
We are measuring here in the micron areas.
So this is point measuring, not scanning.
It's point measurement. We see here one of our newest products with this fancy new color.
Oh, for the Corolla?
That's a good color.
Yeah, yeah.
Like ours.
Yeah. We had this B14, B16 product, but the Evo.
That's a new line.
The new line, they have got these new lines, and we have made a lot of developments and testing with the painter until we get a stable paint.
Right,
yeah?
Right.
And we have a lot of variants. So this is the challenge here. Our equipment has to be very flexible.
Yep.
And to can use for the different products. Yeah?
Wow. How long would it take to do a full measurement of something? Like,
yeah, if
to pass the QA check?
Yes. So for this one, if we make it manually, it depends how many stuff you have there, half an hour, 45 minutes. If you go here, the program is running. Yeah, you can
You can set up an automatic.
It's CNC mode, it's about 10 minutes.
Yes.
So that's just automated.
Automated, yeah. Yeah, you need some time to program it, but this is once. And then the program is running, the equipment is running, you put the part down for 5 to 7 minutes. In the serial production, you need, with the manual test, it's around about 30 minutes.
Yeah, okay.
And this is the idea to get more and more on the CMM and to reduce the manual.
Right, and then it's the same way every single time.
Exactly. It's the same points, it's the same. You can compare, you have the values, you have the databases.
Right.
And we can make capability studies and so on. So we have different measurement systems here. We have here the micro view, which optical testings. So this is the area where you have then the connection with the car.
Yep.
You know?
Yeah, you're pushing would go in.
There. Yes, exactly. So and then we have parts, as we told, from suppliers, new PPAP parts that come in. And the incoming inspection, we have some incoming inspections here, but the most of them are in our warehouse in Schwerte.
Okay.
Yeah. So we have here the micro view, then we have here the contograph.
So here we have our contour measuring machine. It's designed to grab the outer contour of the part. So it moves really slowly, hold the part. This is even fast for this machine,
really?
And just for rush.
Yeah.
Jump purposes.
So it's just pushing until it feels a pressure, basically.
Exactly. And this is why you see this equipment. You can do both, two parts in once, because you make on the one side. And then you can measure also the bores inside.
Okay. Oh yeah, you can flip it and it will go upwards into.
So this is more the area for the dimensional test. Let's go to the material tests.
Yeah.
I think there will be also some interesting stuff for you. You have of course raw material, but you have also finished piston rods, for example. Mm-hmm. And then we have to look if we get the material from our suppliers. Is the material specification according the drawing specification.
Right.
And then you have here, for example, the hardness measurements. If you want to start.
Yeah.
You can see it over here. You can look here on the screen. You see the surface. And only with one click,
It tests it automatically.
Huh. So is it a tiny lens, like a microscopic lens, basically, looking at the material surface?
It makes an impact on the part, and then you see the values by this of the hardness. You see here the specification on the left side, material specification, and then you see there the the size. Yeah.
Does it imprint it? Or?
Impact?
Yeah.
In the metal.
Oh, wow.
And then you check the hardness of the material.
So it's like how difficult it was to make the impression.
Yes, exactly. So this is, there are different specifications, Vickers set, Rockwell, and so on. And based on this, based on the diamond, and then the values, they
wow. What's the threshold for something being good enough or not? Like, what's the variance that is allowed? Is it tiny?
For every material, it's different. You have difficult specification.
Okay.
Yeah, exactly. It's different if you measure steel, for example, but also you can measure something like gummy and so on, and it depends on the parts. And this is the good stuff. It is specified by the design, by the test they are doing, and we are only checking if the parts are according to the specification.
Right. Yeah. That's interesting.
So the spring characteristic, the spring rate.
Yeah, so it's actually verifying that it's the spring rate that it's claimed to be. Yeah.
Exactly.
That's satisfying. Yeah, that's satisfying.
Yeah, I think until 25 kilonewton, right? Is this 20, much?
20.
Can you run this like a shock dyno with the, like the whole assembly? With the spring and the...
Yeah. Yes.
That's neat, because then you can test it in chunks and then see it combined or together what it's doing.
So, and what you see here is we have the different components of a damper, and like springs, raw material, and we for every one you need a special measurement equipment.
Yeah.
Yeah. For example, if we go now next, the tensile test, where we check the weld strength. These machines are also in the production, so also the colleagues from the production.
Also, it'll pull till it snaps.
Yeah, the pull. I think the move was there.
The welding is not damaged. That's important.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And in order to see that high of stress, like it would never realistically see
never
that high of
would have. Yeah, this is the point. We check what is the weakest. And if this is keeping, then you will never have a problem in your part.
Earlier in the day, we had seen these very pieces being welded onto the initial outer tubes as the first step on the production line. It was pretty awesome to see what it would have gone through to make it to that point in the first place.
So this is the area for the material testing. And now we go to the corrosion test. So here some stuff is already prepared for you.
Cool.
You see here some parts. We have two areas where we can test them. You see this on this side better, the scratch test. So the one side.
So you'll mar it up.
Yes, exactly, yeah. The test how good is the painting keeping on the parts. And we test them for at least 480 hours, simulating 10 years by doing this test with these conditions about 480 hours.
You're not simulating that much time, you're leaving it in there for that much time.
Yes, exactly. Yeah. Normally it's closed, yeah, and then we test on the chambers. And if you see there, we have parts which are painted, but you see also parts which have a coat, which are not painted.
Okay.
So
it's not raw material. You can see it over here. You got here it is the metal, and over here,
it's coated.
It's coated.
So and we had a lot of improvements in the last years ago, and the coating and so on. We could double durability. So we have an external supplier who is a specialist for coatings.
Okay.
And they are also delivering to us and to other automotive standards, and so they are the experts.
Okay.
And we are only checking, they do also the checks, but we are make also some checks if the process from our supplier is still stable, right? Salt spray test is the wording for this. And now I would go to the fourth area. We see here is the room for analysis and diagnostic. So if there are any stuff in the field, any problems and so on, then the parts come here and the colleagues are checking the parts here. Of course, they can use also the other stuff from the lab. So they go on the 3D, they go on the material inspection, but this is so the area. And interesting is, of course, the VDA, the master VDA. So this is our master machine, and all production machines are linked with this and compared with this so that we have the same range. And I think Jens can show you VDA test. Yeah? Right. There are some movements.
Real experience.
We can we make a VDA test of the characteristics, gas force and friction, and the test has two characteristics with 1.8 ampere and with 0 ampere. So we can switch between the characteristics.
Oh, okay, for the damptronic, you can tell it what setting it's on.
Damptronic.
Yeah, yeah. This was a unique experience, as this was the test of a damptronic product similar to what we had just installed on our F30 project back at home. This side of like technology and everything, I'm assuming is advancing still pretty quickly as just everything, like 3D scanning and all the machines, all the things that you're doing now is faster and faster.
And faster and faster, and we see also now the next generations with cobots, and then we see cobots with laser scanning and so on. Mm-hmm. Also for the measurement equipment, it gets higher. And this is really good for us because we're a small plant, so we have our people here, but we have other people in the other plants, and every plant is working on one future measurement equipment.
Yeah.
And then we can make networking and say, okay, we have find out this, are you fine? Then we have only to buy, you know?
Yeah.
And I think this is one positive aspect of us, of Bilstein, that we are so big and can spare experiences.
It's very impressive.
I hope so.
Yeah.
I think this was also for us a very cool opportunity to
show
ourselves.
To show this, behind the scenes, for sure.
Yes, behind the scenes,
As with most of our experiences here in Germany, we left these behind-the-scenes learning opportunities with such a greater understanding and appreciation as to what goes into each product our partners pour their hard work into, all for us to be able to supply our customers with the best parts possible.